The Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, presented before Parliament a motion to approve a proposal by government to borrow up to 455.03 million, equivalent to 1.73 trillion, to be arranged by Standard Chartered Bank, comprising of euros 272.33 million from the NEXI facility, 40% from the Islamic Corporation for the Insurance of Investment and Export Credit Facility.
Motion of resolution of Parliament to authorize government to borrow up to euros 3550.3 million, equivalent to 455.03 million, equivalent to USD 464.13 million, from Standard Chartered Bank and other financial institutions as budget support to finance the development and infrastructure budget for the financial year 2022-2023 be approved by this House. Those in favour say on the contrary, nay.
A consortium of finance institutions arranged will provide the loan Standard Chartered Bank UK, provided by Nippon Export and Investment Insurance, Abu Dhabi Fund for Economic Development, and Islamic Corporation for the Insurance of Investment and Export Credit. It has a maturity of 10 years with a grace period of 4 years and a tentative interest of 5.24%. While presenting the report, the National Economic Committee observed that there are intermediaries who are making the cost of a loan very expensive and faulting the government for not going for direct sourcing of loans.
The minister has just stated that the terms are yet to be revised as per the advice of the Attorney General, and is in agreement with the majority report, which recommended and even questioned sovereignty. Now, we cannot approve this loan because the purpose, as you stated, is clear. When we are passing the revenue side, we approved a 2.5 expenditure of budget support, trillion. Therefore, what is required of this House largely is to approve terms. We cannot approve a process of renegotiation.
The committee recommended the Ministry of Finance to negotiate provisions relating to waivers of sovereign immunity to avoid exposing critical government assets to creditors in case of any default.
The much needed counter-fiscal policy support at a time when the economy is recovering. Failure to approve the request implies that approved development budget for the financial year 2022-2023 will not be financed.
However, the opposition, through a minority report presented by the Katikamu South Member of Parliament, Hassan Kirumira, protested approval of the loan, citing tough terms and conditions.
And in effect, the value of the total loan in euros of 455 is what we are talking about. But the actual take home, the actual amount that we are getting as a country is 409.5 million euros. Of course, this is upfront. Remember, we're supposed to pay 45 million euros upfront to Standard Chartered Bank UK. So now that difference between what we are supposed to get and the actual amount that is coming to us in form of a loan is totally unacceptable.
Tension mounted on the floor of Parliament as opposition casted doom over alleged scarcity of liquidity in government, which is used by government to persuade Parliament on this loan, mentioning recent government expenditures.
That's one of the options that we are looking at, because we are dissatisfied with the manner in which this loan has been passed by Parliament, because the Honorable Minister had just informed the House that the Attorney General has written to have the unfair terms reviewed. And we were saying that it is better that we wait for those terms, for the review of the terms, and then the House can maybe consider the passing the loan or not passing it. But the House did not wait for that, and because they are the majority, they have ended up passing the loan, and we are very dissatisfied. So we hope to actually also take that route of court.
Constitutional mandate. I've read the Constitution as is. Right, Honourable Speaker. The other argument being flying around, that government is stuck is that there is no money to do work. I believe, Right Honourable Speaker, this is blackmail of this Parliament. They have just spent under 3%, 1.4 trillion in supplemental expenditure. And the minister, where this is honest, where have they spent the money? 89 billion given to Sudil to build a marina. They've just given 127 billion to Atiak.
Shame.
They've just spent 800 of our money.
Shame.
On defense expenditure.
Shame. Shame.
They've just spent part of that money, 135 billion on classified expenditure under State House. So there is no scarcity of resources. There is wrong appropriation.
The State Minister Musasizi conceded that some conditions need to be negotiated, but assured Parliament that issues around terms and conditions are going to be harmonized after Parliament approval. Despite a spirited fight by opposition to stay approval of the loan, the ayes had it at the end of the day.
Madam Speaker.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.
There is a motion.